gonna move this little log. Chunks are falling off, it's split or resplit. I don't have to noodle that log. Look at that. That big old crack is already noodled. That's it, folks. Sharpen the saw and feel. Get back to it.
there you go, folks. If I counted right, that's 4 rounds. Made almost 2 full rows, and that is almost enough to fill the 4-foot rack. Well, one of them anyway. So yeah, those big rounds make the wood in a hurry, but they're also harder to handle. So yeah, I tried to make a little more of a variety, some smaller pieces like those two there in the center, that one there. Trying to limit them, because this wood is not quite set to go, but give it a week and it should be ready to go, especially for next weekend. And 2 rounds from the cut from the previous video, the 550 XP, when it's setting the auto tune, that two rounds from that made almost a full row. So if I had those 2 rounds, just that one big ash log alone would have been more than enough to fill a 4-foot rack. So yeah, it fluffs up pretty good when you split the big ones up. The little ones may actually compact. So I'm getting a fair amount of wood out of this log pile, so it's nice splitting stuff. You could see that it struggled on some of the knottier pieces. There's 2 chunks of rounds back to back, or 4 halves in this case, where they had a shared knot between those 4 halves. So yeah, it struggled a little bit, as you could see, but it went through it. If it started to stall, I would have just backed off and hit it from the other side, or in a different spot, you know, to make it easier. But as big as that piece was, you know, it got to split it down the middle the first time usually, or some people would have just whittled off the corners there. That probably what it should have done, but I got it done. So I'm going to get back to work and let you get back to your own cutting. So until next time, folks, take care, get out there and do something.